The most succinct definition of a topos is a category with finite limits and power objects. What is nice about this definition is that it is motivated by the needs of a working mathematician. You can compare this to any of the definitions of the theory of sets. And while the theory of sets can encode all of mathematics into a common language, some of the axioms which define it are simply ways to avoid internal contradictions of the naive approach, and are not directly applicable to the vast majority of mathematics. However, with that being said, most of us are better acquainted with some set theory. We'll first look at the constructions necessary for mathematics in the theory of sets, where the primary relation is membership, and translate this to a categorical theoretic structure, where everything must be defined in terms of morphisms. Then we can see directly where the definition of a topos comes from. First, you can't do set theory without elements. An element in a set should be thought of as an isolated dot in a bag. The categorical notion of an element, little x and big X, or more precisely a global element, because as we'll see, there are more general quote-unquote elements in a category, is a morphism from the terminal object to the object x, which names the element little x in it. So at the very least, we need to have a terminal object, which will classify the global elements in our category. Second, if we want to model space, we need a notion of a Cartesian product. The categorical notion is a binary product. It is uniquely specified up to unique isomorphism by the universal mapping property it enjoys. And this allows us to decompose more complicated functions into its components. The existence of a terminal object, which is an empty product, and binary products is enough to prove that the category has finite products. Three, such a big part of mathematics in school is finding roots of a function, or equivalently, finding the intersection of two functions. So categorically, a quote-unquote solution of two morphisms is the equalizer of the morphisms. The existence of finite products and equalizers is equivalent to the existence of finite limits in a category, which is the first requirement for a category to be a topos. So we have left to motivate power objects. In the category of sets, it is important to collectivize subsets of a set so that we may formalize statements which quantify over subsets. For example, the description of a real continuous function f at a point x requires a quantification over open neighborhoods of x and open neighborhoods of fx. The categorical definition characterizes power sets by observing that the membership relation enjoys a universal mapping property analogous to the universal mapping property of exponentials. In fact, in our examples, we will give power objects as exponentials of an object of truth values, which is also known as the subobject classifier. And it turns out that a topos has an equivalent description as a Cartesian closed category with a subobject classifier.